Finally tonight, a story about a young girl who's been given the gift of play. Ella Morton was born without bones in one of her hands. A traditional prosthetic hand would have cost up to $10,000. But thanks to one organization, Ella can play just like her sisters at no cost to her family. The story was produced by Mary Williams, a Gwen Ifill Legacy Fellow from Hughes STEM High School in Cincinnati, Ohio.
Advanced technology is changing the way we all live our lives. But for 4-year-old Ella Morton and her mother, Heather, it has made a huge difference. Thanks to some engineering students and a 3D printer at the University of Cincinnati, Ella is able to enjoy the same activities as most children her age.
When Ella was born, she has no fingers. She has no bones in the palm of her hand. She has bones up to her wrist, and she can flex at her wrist, but that's pretty much where her bones stop. She's always been very outgoing and doesn't let anything stop her.
So, Ella, what do you call your special hand?
Lucky fan, because me and Mo have a lucky fan like me.
Eden Barkis, Jacob Granger, and Deshaun Anand are engineering students and members of Enable UC, a student group collaborating with Enable, an open-source organization that provides a variety of cost-effective prosthetic assistive devices.
One of Enable UC's main missions is to provide 3D printed prosthetics for children. Prosthetics are very expensive, and children grow at a rapid rate.
This is the second hand we've given Ella. And so, like, if she was buying a fully commercial, fully marketed prosthetic, every 2 years you're going to need a new hand, and where we can just be like, oh yeah, we'll just print you off another one.
Biggest thing is getting the right measurements of the patient and understanding the mechanics of a patient, because each patient's a little bit different, and how they use their hand and how they hope to use their hand are all, you know, different variables you have to take into account.
It's incredible that we can give someone a prosthetic and give them the opportunity to have full function in both hands.
Jacob Noor, now a medical student at the Cleveland Clinic, founded the Enable UC program in the fall of 2015 to promote 3D printing technology as a way to bridge the gap between engineering and medicine.
Ella, I will say, is probably my favorite. I mean, you could tell she lit up when we gave her this hand, and she was able to, you know, catch a tennis ball for the first time ever, which is pretty amazing.
Ella's mother says her daughter can do so much more now that she has two hands.
I don't think they totally get how much of an impact they made on our family and Ella. The first thing that she's always said when she puts it on, she's like, look, I have two hands now, mommy, just like my sisters, and I can hold both Barbies, and I can play, and I can do all the same things as my sisters do. Or I like to think that we've never made her feel different, but this just makes it feel more normal.
For PBS NewsHour Student Reporting Labs, I'm Mary Williams.
Great story. On the NewsHour online right now, merely seeing a political symbol like an elephant or a donkey can cause you to reject facts that you would otherwise support. That's according to a new study. Learn more about the science of partisan ranking on our website, pbs.org/newshour.